time to start a fire.
Whoa, whoa, Danny, what are you doing? This fire is completely unsafe.
Although this fire can be put out by water, some fires, such as grease fires and electrical fires, need to be put out with foam. Want to know how we're going to make that, Danny?
Yeah, how are we
going to
do that?
Well, we're going to create a recipe that's kind of similar to what wildland firefighters use to put out wildfires. So it's going to be a foam, and they use it to help protect themselves, local inhabitants whose houses might be at risk, and the forest to be safer. So it's going to be super exciting. Let's go!
Oh, neato!
Woo!
Required ingredients include baking soda, white vinegar, dish soap, 2 jars, stir stick, an overflow chamber, and for the experiment, we'll need a fireproof container, a lighter, and some sort of fire fuel such as dry leaves and paper. First, measure 1/2 cup of vinegar into a jar. Add a drop of red food coloring to dye the mixture to match the fire foam used by wildland firefighters. Next, add 2 squeezes of dish soap into the vinegar and stir. This will help to create the foaming aspect and create a sort of cover or lid on the fire, which helps to prevent fire from getting access to oxygen. Then, measure 1/3 cup of baking soda into the other jar. Be sure to break up any clumps. Place the jar of baking soda into the overflow chamber. Next, pour the vinegar mixture into the baking soda. By doing this, we will be making CO2, which fires don't like and will kill the fire. Once we do this, stay ready. The foam will erupt out of the container and extinguish our fires. Here we go! To test the fire foam in action, what we did was create a model of wildland fuels, which consisted of broken up dead leaves and sticks, as well as some paper and a fireproof container. So to test the foam, we're gonna light the fuel on fire to simulate a slow burning wildfire. So when you do this, make sure you're outside and away from flammable materials. So once you have lit the fire, pour the foam over the unburned areas and note how the fire reacts at the barrier of the fire foam, as the foam should prevent the unburned leaves from catching fire. Then, pour the foam over the burning fuels and note how the fire is suppressed. You can attempt to relight the burned area to see the effectiveness of foam in preventing reignition.
Thanks for tuning in, naturalists. If you'd like to see more cool experiments, follow us at Truckee Meadows Park Foundation Student Stewards Program page or subscribe down below.